I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. They beat the clock in Ulster County last night. County Legislature Deputy Clerk Fawn Tantillo, with only minutes to spare and with a police escort, arrived at the post office in Kingston with paperwork that had to be postmarked Thursday. Needed to be mailed out to Albany in order to ensure the county would be able to receive roughly $22 million in potential sales tax revenue. The county legislature had approved a resolution a short time earlier, allowing it to again collect 1% more in sales tax beginning February 1st. Lawmakers had to wait until official confirmation came from the governor's office that the sales tax bill had been assigned. The down-to-the-wire scenario was the result of a legislative logjam caused by Assemblyman Kevin Cahill, who had tied the county sales tax renewal to a county takeover of safety net funding. Cahill and Ulster County Executive Michael Hine have blamed each other for the impasse. An Ulster County grand jury's indicted a New Jersey man for shooting and killing a dog with a bow and arrow back in October. District Attorney Holly Conright says 39-year-old David Moores of Beechwood, New Jersey, was hunting on his sister's property off Weed Road in Pinebush when he shot and killed the dog. The dog was a family pet whose owner witnessed the killing. Moores was charged with aggravated cruelty to animals and hunting deer with the aid of bait. Also indicted by an Ulster County grand jury, Quashawn Thomas. The 20-year-old Kingston man had been taken into custody following a domestic dispute last November when, according to police, he tied up a woman, beat her, and burned her with a hot knife. The woman was able to escape to a neighbor's house and call police. The indictment includes charges of unlawful imprisonment, menacing, and criminal obstruction of breathing. Prior to his arrest, Thomas fought with officers after jumping out of a second-story window. It's been the target of protests. The plan submitted by officials at St. Luke's Cornwall Hospital to close their Cornwall campus emergency room from 10 p.m. to 10 a.m. and have Cornwall area emergency patients travel to the hospital's Newburgh campus during those overnight hours. State Senator Bill Larkin and Assemblyman James Skoufis met this week with the state health commissioner to discuss the local opposition and to urge the state to thoroughly examine a plan that Larkin says could put emergency patients living in the Cornwall area at potential risk.
The city of Newburgh has one of the most dangerous cities in America. There are times when that city has bogged down about shootings, and that whole hospital is closed. What happens with the five municipalities that surround here that use Cornwall and St. Luke's? They then, if this happens after 10 o'clock at night, where do these people go? If the hospital is closed down, there's no emergency service, and there may be somebody with a heart attack, a gallbladder, a major accident on 9W. So we have to put all of those into play.
Larkin says if the hours are reduced at the Cornwall ER, he and others will look into the possibility of allowing civilians to be sent to the nearby Keller Army Hospital at West Point under emergency circumstances. In Sullivan County, a Hurleyville man has been arrested for a series of home burglaries where copper piping was cut out of heating systems in the buildings. Town of Fallsburg police charged 23-year-old Vincent Blanchard with four felony counts of burglary, along with grand larceny, criminal mischief, and possession of burglar's tools. Police say the break-ins occurred at three homes in Hurleyville and one in Woodridge. A discouraging Labor Department report regarding employment in Orange and Dutchess counties. Labor statistics released Thursday indicate the two counties lost roughly 4,100 private sector jobs last year. About 600 of them were lost in local government positions and schools. The 2013 job loss was about a 100 in Sullivan County, while Ulster County gained 400 jobs last year. Recent IBM worker cutbacks were reportedly a factor in the private sector job decline in both Orange and Dutchess counties. And Hudson Valley Congressman Sean Patrick Maloney paid a visit to the Purple Heart Hall of Honor in New Windsor earlier today, part of his push to pass legislation in Washington that would authorize the U.S. Treasury to mint a series of Purple Heart commemorative coins at the West Point Mint.
And what's great about that is that it not only spreads the word of the sacrifice of these brave Americans, but some of the proceeds of that of those coins would come back and benefit this institution. And so it would help in real tangible ways, not just by spreading the word and by honoring those who served, but by really helping us today, right here, at this wonderful Hall of Honor to expand our efforts, to expand the services we provide and the capacity to honor those who serve.
Maloney's proposal, if enacted, would result in the minting of commemorative $5 gold coins, $1 silver coins, and half-dollar clad coins that would be sold in limited quantities in 2017, with proceeds going to the Hall of Honor. Maloney and State Senator Bill Larkin say the coins would help raise awareness of the sacrifices made by America's service members who were killed or wounded in combat. There are currently about 191,000 Purple Heart recipients in the Hall of Honor database. Officials say the coins could aid in their ongoing efforts to track down the thousands more out there deserving of recognition. There's a little snow in our weekend forecast. Saturday will be cloudy and not quite so bitter cold with periods of snow. Could get anywhere from a dusting to 2 inches or a bit more of accumulation. Highs will be up around 25 degrees. Sunday will be partly cloudy and the thermometer will be hard-pressed to make it any higher than 20 degrees. We'll stay on top of what's happening by reading the Times-Herald Record this weekend. And breaking news is just a click away right here at Record Online. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter.